Hello everyone, today we shall start with the law of chemical combination. Now, what are the laws of chemical combination? Now, and why do we need it? Now, the law of chemical combination deals with some empirical laws that govern chemical change. So, during a chemical combination or during chemical reaction, chemical changes happen. So, how does the changes happen? What are the terms associated with it? So we'll discuss that in law of chemical combination. Under the law of chemical combination, we'll basically deal with six different laws. The first law is the law of conservation of mass. This law was put forward by scientist Antoine Lavoisier, according to which the in a chemical reaction, the initial weight of reacting substance is equal to the final weight of the product. That is, mass can neither be created nor be destroyed, but it can be transferred from one form to another. And in other words, it may also be stated as the total mass of the reactant is equal to the total mass of the product. Now, Lavoisier performed an experiment in which he took HgO and decomposed HgO to Hg and O2. So when he found initial mass of HgO, he has taken already, weighed already, and after the decomposition Hg and O2, he found the mass of the reactant, and he got that the sum of the mass of the reactant is equal to the masses of the product. That is, the mass of reactant equal to mass of product. Lavoisier's experiment states that 2Hg combined with decomposes to give 2Hg plus O2. Mercuric oxide has a mass 433.2 gram. Hg and O, when you combine again, you get 433.2 gram. That indicates that the mass of reactant is equal to mass of product. Another example is when 2Mg combines with oxygen to give 2MgO, we can again note that the mass of the reactant is equal to mass of the product. The transformation may take place during a chemical reaction of an atom to another, but the total mass will remain the same. Now, the law of conservation of mass can be demonstrated by the union of hydrogen and oxygen to give water. If H2O and O2 are weighed before they unite, it will be found that the combined weight is equal to the weight of the water formed. The law of conservation of mass is also called as law of indestructibility of matter. So, matter is not possible to be destructed. It remains constant. There is no detectable gain or loss of mass in a chemical reaction. So this is the first law. That is, in a chemical change, no matter how big the bang, the mass is neither gained nor lost. Now the second law is law of constant composition or law of definite proportion. This law was put forward by a scientist named Joseph Prost, according to which different sample of same compound always contain elements combined together in same proportion by mass. So if you are having a compound, the elements present in the compound will have the fixed proportion by mass in that particular compound. Even if you change the source, but the compound composition will remain the same. For example, water consists of hydrogen and oxygen atom. You all know the formula of water, that is H2O. That is, for two parts of hydrogen, you have one part of oxygen. One hydrogen atom weighs 1 gram, so 2 hydrogen will weigh 2 gram. And one oxygen atom weighs 16 gram, so it is 2:16. That is, one hydrogen needs 8 oxygen. So for one hydrogen atom, that is 1 gram of H, you require 8 gram of O. And that is always fixed in the compound called H2O. The hydrogen composition, if I find the percentage of H and O in H2O, the percent of hydrogen is 11% by mass and oxygen is 89%. So you take water from any source, the composition of H and O will remain same. That is, hydrogen percentage is 11 always in H2O and oxygen percentage is 89 in H2O. Now if you take water from laboratory or from rain, river, water pump, hydrogen one part is equal to 8 part of oxygen by mass. Any source you take, the compound will have same composition. The third law is law of multiple proportion. This law was put forward by John Dalton. Now what does it state? When two elements combine to form more than one compound, the masses of one element which combine with the fixed mass of the other element are in ratio of small whole number or simple multiple ratio. That is, when you are having two elements, they combine to give two or more than two compound, then mass of one element will remain same and mass of the other element will change, and the other element whose mass is not fixed will have a simple multiple ratio. For example, carbon combines with oxygen to give two compound, carbon monoxide CO and carbon dioxide. In carbon monoxide, one atom of carbon combined with one atom of oxygen, that is 12 part by mass of carbon combined with 16 part by mass of oxygen. In carbon dioxide, that is CO2, 12 part of carbon combined with 32 part by mass of oxygen. So you can see that the mass of carbon in both the compound is constant, but mass of oxygen in carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide has a simple ratio, 16:32 or 1:2. That is, mass of carbon is fixed, but mass of oxygen has a simple ratio, 1:2 in carbon monoxide to carbon dioxide. This is law of multiple proportion. Now we shall discuss the fourth law, which is law of reciprocal proportion. According to this, when two different elements separately combine with fixed mass of the third element, that is, you have a third element having a fixed mass, A combined with C, C has a fixed mass, B combined with C, C always has a fixed mass. So now when A and B will combine, they will also have a simple ratio of it. That is, when you are dealing with two element A and B, let that be carbon and oxygen, they combine separately with fixed mass of hydrogen. Carbon combined with hydrogen to give methane, oxygen combined with hydrogen to give water. Now when carbon oxygen will combine, they form carbon dioxide. So if I take 1 gram of hydrogen, 3 gram of carbon, 8 gram of oxygen, 1 gram hydrogen combined with 3 gram carbon to give methane, 1 gram carbon react with 8 gram oxygen to give water. So 3 gram carbon will react with 8 gram of oxygen to give carbon dioxide. This is the law of reciprocal proportion. The next law is Gay-Lussac's law of gaseous volume. Law of gaseous volume was given by a scientist named Gay-Lussac, and it deals with the volume ratio of reactant and product. According to this, when gases react together, they always do so in equal volume, which bear a simple ratio to one another and to the volume of the product, provided all measurements of volume are done under similar condition of temperature and pressure. That is, when two gases combine under similar condition of temperature pressure, the volume ratio of reactant and product will have a simple whole number ratio. For example, when N2 combine with H2 to give NH3, 1 volume of N2 combined with 3 volume of H2 to give 2 volume of NH3. So the volume ratio is 1:3:2. That is a whole simple whole number ratio. Similarly, 2 more volume of hydrogen combined with 1 volume of oxygen to give 2 volume of H2O. That is, the ratio is 2:1:2. 1 volume of hydrogen combined with 1 volume of chlorine to give 2 volume of HCl. So the ratio is 1:1:2. So if I take x ml of H2, I will have x ml of Cl2, but the HCl volume will be 2x. So that is the volume ratio, Gay-Lussac's law. Now next is Avogadro's law. Avogadro's law was put forward by Avogadro. If gases are kept under equal under similar condition of temperature pressure, then equal volume of gas will contain equal number of molecules. That is, equal volume of gases under identical condition of temperature pressure contain equal number of molecules. So if you have 1 mole of hydrogen, you will have Avogadro number of particles, and the volume would be 22.4 liter under standard temperature and pressure. So under a set of temperature pressure which are fixed for two gas, both the gases are under same temperature, same pressure, and you take two gases in equal volume, then the number of particle in both the gas in that particular equal volume will also be equal.
For example, if I take 22.4 liter of hydrogen and 22.4 liter of oxygen, then they will contain 6.022 10 to the power 23 molecules. So Avogadro number is equal, that is the number of molecule is equal to the equal volume of gas if they are contained under same condition of temperature and pressure. So that was law of chemical combination. Now we'll discuss in detail Dalton's atomic theory. Now Dalton's atomic theory was a theoretical proof to validate different laws, and it was been given by John Dalton. Now what are the postulates given by John Dalton? John Dalton said that matter is composed of very tiny microscopic particle called atom. Atoms are smallest particle which cannot be further subdivided. That is, atom is an indivisible particle. Atom can neither be created nor being destroyed. Atom of elements are identical in same in size, shape, mass and in other properties. So if I take hydrogen element, the atoms of all hydrogen atom will remain same. They will have all properties same. Atom of different element are different in their properties. So I can't tell one atom of hydrogen is equal to one atom of oxygen. One atom of hydrogen has one electron, one proton and no neutron. But one atom of oxygen has 8 electron, 8 proton and it may have 7 or 6 neutron. So atom of hydrogen or atom of different elements are different in properties. Atom combine with each other in simple whole numbers. That is, hydrogen atom may combine with another hydrogen to give H2. All chemical reaction are due to combination or separation of atom. So reaction or combination is taking place in a chemical reaction. So when a chemical reaction takes place, atom either combine or they get separated. Now, limitation of Dalton's theory. Dalton stated that atom are the smallest indivisible particle. By the end of 18th century, we came to know that atom are not indivisible, but they can be further subdivided. By the discovery of subatomic particle, electron, proton, neutron, we can state that atoms are no longer indivisible. You can divide atom. Atom of same element are not similar in all respect. Atom of similar element may have same atomic number, but the mass may differ. That is, atomic mass may differ, and such atom of same element which does not have same mass are called isotopes. Atom of different element are not different in all respect. Atom of different element that have the same atomic mass are called isobar. Different element combine in simple whole number ratio to form compound. This is not seen in compound like sugar, sucrose, C12H22O11. You don't have a simple whole number ratio. It does not explain the existence of allotropes. So these are the limitations of Dalton's atomic theory. Now we shall discuss a term called as atom. Now what are atom? We all learn atom, atom, atom. So atom are the building block of an matter. So atoms are the building block of matter. Earlier definition, according to Dalton's theory, atoms were considered to be the indivisible particle and they cannot be created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. Atoms are very small in size and they are not seen with our naked eyes. And the size of the atom is indicated by the radius of atom called its atomic radius. And the atomic radius is measured in unit called nanometer. Atom cannot be seen with naked eyes. So modern technology has risen up. So we can see now the image of an atom, surface image of atom with the instrument called SEM or TEM. These are specially designed microscope. Hydrogen, being the smallest atom, has the smallest radii, which is 0.037 nanometer. Nitrogen 0.074. The size is very, very small. So atoms are smallest indivisible particle according to earlier concept, according to Dalton's theory. And atom, in the later definition, if you take, it's being classified into three subatomic particle: electron, proton and neutron. And now we'll discuss atomic mass.
So mass is a characteristic property of matter. The mass of an atom is known as atomic mass. Atom of given element are identical in shape, size, mass, chemical properties, etc. Atom of different element have different masses and chemical properties. Now how to get the mass of an atom? The mass of atom is called atomic mass. Now how do we determine it? Now to determine the mass of an atom, because they are very small in size, it's very difficult. So we compare it, or we give it in a unit called as atomic mass unit. The unit of the mass of an atom is atomic mass unit, or AMU. John Dalton suggested that mass of an hydrogen should be taken as a reference to find the atomic mass. But by later, we started to take the reference as oxygen. But the IUPAC committee in 1961 adopted carbon-12 as the reference element, and we started to find out the relative atomic mass. That is, the atomic mass of individual atom were compared with the mass of carbon-12. And later on, we came up with the term, instead of atomic mass unit, the unit was written as U, which is called unified atomic mass. And atomic mass unit is 1/12 the mass of carbon-12 atom. So 1 AMU is 1/12 the mass of carbon-12 atom. Or 1 U, unified mass, is 1/12 the mass of carbon-12 atom. Hence, the relative atomic mass of the atom of an element is defined as the average mass of the atom as compared to 1/12 the mass of 1 carbon-12 unit. For example, the mass, atomic mass of oxygen is 16 U. Now we shall discuss atom we have done. Now we will deal with molecules and ions. The smallest particle of substance is an atom. Atom is very small in size and it cannot be further subdivided according to Dalton's theory. Two or more atoms of same or different element combine to form a stable entity called molecule. A molecule is defined as a stable entity of a substance capable of independent existence. So, smallest part of matter is atom. Atom combine to give molecules. Now, molecules are smallest entity of substance which are capable of independent existence. A molecule is smallest particle of an element or a compound that can exist independently and possesses all the properties of the substance to which it belongs. The constituting atom of a molecule are held together by strong attractive force. For example, in H2 is a molecule which is made of two atoms of hydrogen which are bonded chemically. Hydrogen can also combine with oxygen to form water molecule. So molecule is smallest particle either of an element or a compound, but that should exist independently. That is, alone it can exist. Now, at molecule of elements. Molecule of elements are composed of identical atom. For example, H2, O2, Cl2, N2, and these are all made of same kind of atom. Now, N2O2 are called diatomic because they are made of two atoms of either N2 if I talk, they are made of two atoms of N, and oxygen is made of two atoms of O. Whereas three atoms of O combine to form O3, which is ozone. The atomicity of oxygen is 3. That is, the number of atom in a molecule is called its atomicity. How many atom are in a molecule? That is equal to atomicity. Now, the atomicity of helium, argon, neon, they alone exist. So, they don't have, helium is He. You don't have He2, He3, etc. So, they are monoatomic. Oxygen exists as O2, hydrogen H2, and nitrogen N2, chlorine Cl2. So, these are diatomic. Phosphorus exists as P4, so it's tetraatomic. Sulfur exists as S8, so it's polyatomic. Now, molecule of a compound. The molecule of a compound are formed when atom of different elements, and please understand, atom of different element, when they combine chemically in definite proportion, you get molecule of a compound. For example, molecule of carbon dioxide is CO2, which consists of one atom of carbon and two atom of oxygen. In another term, we can understand that in water, two hydrogen atom combined with one atom of oxygen. Two atom of N2 combined with six atom of H2 to give NH3. Carbon dioxide one carbon combined with two atom of oxygen. In carbon monoxide, one carbon atom combined with one atom of oxygen. So these are compounds with the molecules of compound. Now we'll see again in detail atomic mass. Atomic mass is the mass of an atom in unit AMU. Atomic mass is defined as mass exactly equal to 1 by 12th mass of one carbon 12 atom. So 1 by 12th the mass of carbon 12 atom is 1 AMU. And it is a relative scale, as we know it is with the respect of carbon 12. On this scale, hydrogen has an atomic mass 1.008 AMU and oxygen has mass 16.00 AMU. Or 1 AMU is equal to 1.67 10 to the power minus 24 gram, which is very, very small. Now, atomic mass is given in the periodic table as average atomic mass because naturally occurring elements contain isotope. You don't have all elements, like all the atom of same element, to have same physical and chemical property. You may have some physical property differing, that is atomic mass of the same atom may be different, like hydrogen has three isotopes, protium, tritium, deuterium, where the atomic number is same but mass are different. So in such case we don't find atomic mass, but instead we find average atomic mass. The average atomic mass is weighted average of atomic masses of isotopes weighted by their respective fractional abundance. So M average is equal to summation of MIFI, where MI is the atomic mass of isotope, FI is the fractional abundance of that isotope. Capital N is the number of isotope of that particular element. Fractional abundance is a fraction of isotope atom in a given sample of element. Now we shall discuss example. Now to find the average atomic mass of lithium. Now lithium has two isotopes, Li with mass 6 and Li with mass 7. And Li 6 has fractional abundance as 0.0742 and Li 7 has 0.9258. So in abundance, nature, more amount of Li 7 exists, but we can't tell Li 6 does not exist. It has certain fraction, that is 0.07. So how to find average mass? The mass of Li 6 is 6.015 multiplied by its fractional abundance, which is 0.0742, plus the fractional abundance of Li 7 into its mass 7.016. When you do the sum, the exact average mass is being calculated as 6.942. So lithium has an average atomic mass 6.942 AMU or 6.942 U. Another example, we shall find the average atomic mass of oxygen. Oxygen in 16 has 99.76% and when it is in 17 isotope 0.04 and 18.2. So average atomic mass is 16 into 99.76 plus 17 into 0.04 plus 18 into 0.20 divided by 100, because these are in percent, so common term will come. 20.2% is equal to 0.20 upon 100. 99.76 is 99.76 divided by 100, so divide by 100 is a. So when you do the average atomic mass, you get as 16 U or 16 AMU. Last example that we will discuss is that average atomic mass of chlorine. Chlorine average atomic mass is 8 of every 10 atoms, that is 35, and 2 chlorine 37. So 35 into 8 plus 37 into 2 divided by 10, because out of 10, it is not in percent, it is of 10. So fractional abundance is 8 by 10 and here 2 by 10. So you take 35 into 8 plus 37 into 2 divided by 10 and you get as 35.4 AMU. So this is about average atomic mass.